Hello everyone, I would like to welcome you all in the tutorial session on page hit analysis. I already explained how you can reach to this page. This is in order to reach to this page, you will use this URL, which is given here. Use your login ID and password, then you will reach to this page. This tutorial has 5 sections, and the sections are getting started, loading the log, parsing the log, counting pages, plotting the results. I will explain this section one by one. So in the first section, that is getting started, here what you will do in this section, you will complete the initial activities such as creating week 2 directory where you will place your program and installing new packages to perform page hit analysis. So here you can see, first of all, you are creating a new directory at this location, project cis2168/tutorials/week2. So in order to use week 2, you have to use mkdir on the terminal and then week 2, then cd week 2 at this location. Then move to your virtual environment, which you created last week. Work on cis2168 is the virtual environment. And after moving here in this virtual environment, install the necessary packages which you will use for page hit analysis. So if you remember, in the very first week, I explained pip command for installing the packages. So here you can see these are the name of the packages, and we are using pip to install these packages and then upgrade your installation, your virtual environment. So once you will complete all these things, you need to download the log file from the shared cloud, and the location for the shared cloud is given here. From here, you can download the log file, and the name of the log file is basic_web.log. Place this log file in week 2 tutorial. In the second section, that is loading the log, what you will do in this section, you will use open function to read the content, to read the log file. So here you can see open function is given, and this is the name of the log file which you want to read, and then for loop, and then print the line, and just follow the instructions to complete complete loading the log file section. In the third section is on parsing the log. I have used the instruction on parsing the log in part 3b in my video lecture of page hit analysis part 3b. So what is parsing the log? Parsing is basically the process of breaking down the log data into small chunks of data and placing the data into its own specific named format or field by following set of rules. So here you can see, this is the IP address of the client of the visitor from where the request is coming. This is nothing but the date and time when the client has sent the request, and this is the URL from where the request is coming. So we'll use this, all this data parsing the log, and we need to import apache_log_parser, and these are nothing but the fields, and we want to break the log data using these fields in small chunks of data, and then follow the steps to complete this section. Section 4 is on counting. Here you will use counter function to count the number of pages. So this is my list. Here the name of the list is page. This is list variable and it is empty in the beginning. This is the name of the file. Here we are running the loop and we are parsing the results. We are breaking the data given in the log file in small chunks of data, and then we are printing the pages. Here you can see I have given counter function to count the number of pages, and then we are printing the count value. After completing this section, you will be ready with the data for plotting. Then the last section of this tutorial is plotting the result. So here you can see if you want to plot the result, so initially your result will be unstructured, so you need to structure your result. So in order to structure your result, you will use data frame. Data frame is in pandas package, so you need to import this package and then convert your unstructured data using the data frame in a structure format, then print the data. After completing this, you can use seaborn package which supports count plot for plotting the data, and then place these two instructions in your program and run your program. Then you will be able to see the plot, and the plot will be saved in the week 2 directory. So this is the end of this week tutorial. So once you will complete all the 5 sections, then you can start working on the tutorial for week 2. So this is the task you need to complete, and this task has 5 questions. Each question will be for 2 marks. After completing all the questions given in task number 1, when you will be ready with your response for each question, place the response in one directory, and the instruction for submission for task 1 for portfolio task is already given in week number 1 module overview video. In the module overview video, you can see that. And then you need to submit your response before the deadline. For the deadline, you can get the deadline on the Blackboard assessment area. And once you will complete the submission and after the deadline, I will start marking your submission, and I will share the feedback for each question with you all. That's all in the tutorial from my side.